Yeah, not too close. That's good.
Thank you.
I have been very close friends for the last 2 hours. We literally met yesterday at the Gruppelli camp, but we've known about each other for roughly 10 years or something. He's pretended to know about me for 10 years. As you've heard, he's kind of the jazz mandolinist in the States. So it's a great pleasure to be here with Don. And we thought, well, we'll put together a jazz set. And then we thought, well, yeah, a little bit of jazz, but then some other stuff as well. So we'll treat you to some things that you might expect and other things that you might not expect. So good luck. That's what I'm saying. So we started off with a song called There'll Never Be Another You, which was written by All Means. By All Means. It was written by All Means. That's the Dutch sense of humor. It sometimes goes a bit flat. You know, I was in Colorado only last week. I don't know if you've ever seen or felt how high it is there. I just got a nosebleed landing the plane there. Anyway, so we're going to continue with a Duke Ellington composition. It's called In a Sentimental Mood. Do you want to start?
Thank you.
All right, that was a piece by Edward Grieg.
Really?
Yeah. Norwegian dance.
It's called, well done, the Norwegian dance, but we call it the Norwegian calypso. So we're going to move on to something that was written a very long time ago, but not as long as Edward Grieg's time. It's a nice, very nice song. You all know it. And Don has offered to sing. There we go.
Kind of a weather oriented song here.
Okay.
Not sure why I thought of doing it. We're in the hot weather.
Thank you.
Thank you.
have one more tune before we melt. And then we're going to have an interval. In which there are drinks, I think. Or maybe no drinks, but certainly watermelon, which I think everybody will need drastically outside. And also, I invite you to sample some CDs over there on the table. We don't have a CD together yet, Don. Why is that, really? I think we should. But in absence of a CD of the two of us, you can buy two CDs, one of mine and one of Don's. How about that? Or just pick and choose, you know. Anyway.
I got a question.
What's the question?
How do I like it so far?
The answer is no, Don. Thank you for ruining a perfectly good concert. Okay, so those last two tunes were Pennies from Heaven and, or three tunes, and The Cuckoo's Nest, which is an Irish traditional which went to America and transformed. So we played two versions and then put in some other stuff as well. And this one was called Recado Bossa Nova, which was written by a guy called Jaume Ferreira. And by the way, the income from the CD all goes to a charity. It's the Children's Fund, Our Children. And for those who would like to hear about extended travels in the US, because finally I've got a visa that's not just for one day, please put your name on the email list there and I'll write you lots of love letters, junk mail, adverts for Rolex Swiss watches, and every now and then a little email about where the next concert will be. So, enough about that. We're going to play one more. It's a tune called Shine. And then we invite you to go outside for a moment. We will do anyway. You ready for this? Thank you. I don't know what. I have no clue. How are we doing? Just nerves.
Except for the idea of grown men making their living like this.
Thank you. Thank you.
we started off with a tune called Swing 39, or, well, it was originally entitled Swing 39, because it was written by this French guy, Django Reinhardt, who is directly responsible for this mess in Northampton called Django Camp. And then we played a tune called How High the Moon. And the next song is a Django Reinhardt composition. Again, it's probably his most famous tune. And we'd like to play it for you and do a little advert here for the Django Reinhardt concert that's happening on Friday in the Music Academy, Academy of Music, Central Station Academy of Arts and Place Thing, Market Square, in Northampton. And I think there are still tickets for the show. It's on Friday night. It starts at 7:38. You'll be able to find out from the web thingy. 7:30, thank you. And I'm meeting a guy called Samson Schmidt, who's a French gypsy and who's been flown in for the festival. And we're supposed to put a concert together. So I'm not thinking about that yet. I'm just thinking about this. I'm loving it. Isn't he great? Don Stiernberg. Yeah. Question, what are our instruments? Well, they're a mandolin and a violin. But maybe, Don, you could tell these people something about your instrument? Something short.
This mandolin was made for me in 1996 by a brilliant luthier named Mike Kennitzer. And his brand name, which he didn't put on the headstock this time, is Nugget. So it's a Nugget.
Is it very expensive? It's gold nugget.
It's
No, it's not very expensive. Okay. Well, it says nugget there, though, on your tailpiece.
Yeah.
It's a silver nugget there. Okay. So, and about this fiddle, it was also built for me in 1805. The violin maker didn't know it was for me yet, but his name was Jean Sohet. Or Sohet, you would call him here. Belgian guy. And I think there is a weird thing here which looks like a Napoleon bullet hit the tree before he used the wood. No, I'm just joking. But it is from 1805, and it's been with me for 10 years now. And it's built according to the Italian model, whatever that means. I just say it. I don't know what it means. Anyway, so, enough about our instruments. They didn't want to hear that at all, did they?
You did.
So, the next tune is called Nuage, which means clouds. It was written by Django Reinhardt in 1941. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Any takers for 7? 1941.
My friend Howard Levy told me story about this tune. I didn't realize until just recently that it was during the war times, it was a song that was picked up as sort of anthem from the French resistance movement. They identified with the tribal clouds because even though there were borders that were being fought over, the clouds were always free to go in whichever direction.
Oh, that's great.
And
ready? Yes. Thank you. this was a piece composed by a friend of mine who's a touring musician and needs a lot of encouragement to compose more tunes because he doesn't really take enough time because he's touring a lot. But he's a budding composer and I think he has talent, so he needs encouragement. So I always play one of his tunes when I'm on tour. That's because he's me. That piece was called Samba for Paula. And now we have a very special surprise for you because there is a lovely lady here who's teaching with me at the camp in Northampton. She plays the fiddle. And we would like to invite her on the stage for a number with us, which I think you all know. So please, your very warm welcome for Karin van Koten. So what are we playing? Thank you. Take?
Oh,
lots more. Doesn't look like you can take lots more.
We only have time for 75 or 80 more songs.
Okay, go on then. Right, well, what's next then? one more tune, don't we? Yeah. Yes, we do.
Yes.
It's called After You've Gone. How fitting is that?
Yeah.
But before we play this song, I would like to thank a very generous and kind friend, and also his wife as well, the gentleman and his gentle wife, and his gentle children, and the gentle house they live in, and the gentle dog they have, for just keeping music live in this amazing venue, and for playing such amazing tennis as well. Thank you very much, Paul. Don Stiernberg. Eight strings. It's murder. Why did they ever build that instrument? I probably for you.
Yeah.
Right. What are we doing here? Okay. ballad or up-tempo?
Up-tempo.
Okay, hands for ballad. Up-tempo. Oh God, ballad, you've lost. Easy then, okay. Good luck.
Who's playing with it? Who's playing the ballad?
We both are at ridiculously high speed.
Thank you. Thank you.